Some popular computer keyboards have a serious flaw right out of the box.
Something else we got to deal with now. Yeah. Consumer Justice reporter Kristen Severance tonight showing us all the new way hackers are able to steal your personal information.
Smart technology may be our future, but Bastille, a cybersecurity company, says it's time to be wary.
Attacks are coming. We can be sure of it. We can't be sure from where.
This one comes from a simple wireless keyboard. A California-based company discovered the security flaw. Using an off-the-shelf USB radio antenna and a laptop with a publicly available software, they're intercepting and recording the signal from this wireless keyboard from as far as 250 feet away. It's a process called key sniffing. Addresses, social security numbers, your birthday, basically anything and everything you type. And you don't need a computer science degree to figure it out.
The average person can do it. If you order the dongle online and then download our open source software from the internet, it's just a couple of lines to type into your console here, and that'll get you up and running sniffing for vulnerable devices in your airspace.
Affected brands include HP, Toshiba, Kensington, Insignia, Radio Shack, Anker, General Electric, and Eagle Tech.
Represents millions of keyboards out in the world.
Millions.
Millions out in the world. The manufacturers make these things and don't check that they've got the vulnerabilities.
The company notified the manufacturers 3 months ago. To date, only three companies, General Electric, Anker, and Kensington, responded and offered a fix.
Others just say, well, it's no big deal.
If your manufacturer is not offering a fix, the company says the only option is to get a wired or Bluetooth keyboard. Kristen Severance, CBS 11 News.
And Kristen tells us that Bastille says what makes keyboards so vulnerable is that they're always transmitting signals. Doesn't stop, even if you aren't actually using your computer. You can look for the affected devices within Kristen's story. That's on our website. Just go to cbsdfw.com.